What's up guys, welcome to Hooson. This will be my first ever Unity tutorial, and today we'll be learning how to optimize our user interface for notch devices. One of the common problems mobile game developers will face are notch devices. There are lots of phones out there with different designs, therefore it is important for developers to optimize their game user interface with multiple devices. In this scene, you can see that I have placed my user interface at the top and bottom of the screen. Before we get started, let's first set up Unity. If you're planning on making mobile games, I would recommend using Simulator instead of Game. Click on the Windows button at the top of Unity and open Package Manager. Click on the gear icon on the left of the search bar. Click on Advanced Project Setting and enable Preview Packages. Under the Packages section, change it to Unity Registry. Search for Device Simulator and install it. You can see that in your game panel, you are able to change from game to simulator. Simulator allows developers to see what their game would look like on different devices. Now as you can see, if my game was to be played on an iPhone 11, the user interface are being cut off at the top. To fix this notch issue is pretty simple. Firstly, enabling safe area displays a rectangle box which tells us where the safe area is at for the device. So what we want to do is to have our user interface within the box. Now let's create a new C# script called Safe Area. We do not need to use the start and update function, so we can go ahead and delete them. And we will use the awake function instead. Firstly, let's create a variable of rectransform, named rectransform. A rect variable named safe area, and two vector2 variable named minimum anchor and maximum anchor. In the awake function, we want to fetch the rect transform from the game object. Safe area equals to screen.safeArea. Minimum anchor equals to safeArea.position. Maximum anchor equals to minimum anchor plus safeArea.size. Next, we want to assign the width and height of the screen into the X and Y position of minimum anchor and maximum anchor. Lastly, we will assign the minimum and maximum anchor point into our rect transform variable. Head back to Unity and we will create an empty game object under canvas called safe area. Change the anchor preset to stretch and set the rect transform to 0. Attach the safe area script onto the safe area game object, and I will drop my background, top, and bottom panel to be a child of it. Now when you click play, you can see that your user interface fits within the safe area of the device. If we were to change our device to, let's say, Huawei, you can see that it fits within the safe area as well. If I want my background to cover the entire screen, I can simply drag my background out of the safe area game object. So that's all for this tutorial. Do hit the like and subscribe button if you enjoyed this video. I will be posting more Unity tutorial and behind the scene of my game dev journey in the future as well. I've recently published a top-down shooter game on Android and iOS, so do check them out. Link to download them will be in the description. I will see you guys in the next video. Peace.